We are close.
We're telling your followers that you've started a live video.
That's awesome.
We have a couple people joining in. Say hello to people.
Hi.
We got 100 in there right now.
People coming in.
Awesome. Well, I want to start off by saying hi. My name's Autumn Miller, if you don't know. Today, we are hosting the Block Live class on Block Dance USA's Instagram. We're going to give you a nice jazz technique class today. It's going to be pretty fun. This is my mom here.
Hey guys, Krista Miller. We are excited. We're here at the Brea Space. This is our actual dance studio that is unfortunately closed right now due to the pandemic. So we've been here trying to do some live classes. You might have also seen us. We were working on some online classes on the Space TV. So we are here. We're going to give you a cool jazz technique class. We'd be about 60 minutes long with about 40 minutes of dancing, 50 minutes of dancing, and maybe 10 to 15 minutes of Q&A at the end.
Yeah, yeah.
So we are going to probably turn off the comments so that way it's not distracting for the class. So you guys can see what's happening. And then we will pop through those at the very end and see if we can get some information going from you guys. So this is our studio. This is actually our fun space wall here where a lot of teachers have come and put all of their energy and hard work in with our students. So they've signed the wall in their own special way, which is really kind of fun. I'll walk you through the dance room where we're going to dance a little bit. We actually have some of our kids, they go to school with us here. Everything from high school and college, and this is where they do their school in the rooms where they have little desks when we're in season. And then we do a lot of training here. We do everything from jazz, hip hop, ballet, technique, jazz funk, singing, acting. We try to really keep everything well-rounded for the dancers, if we can, something extra special like this. And this is where some of the fun magic happens. This is our white room. We also have a black room next door. We thought we'd put you in here because it's nice and easy to see, bright and clean. So hopefully your body is ready to go. It's a little, not early morning here for us, but 9 in the morning for us. Some of you maybe 12 or later, depending on if you're evening across the world. But we want you to spread out. Make sure you have some room. I'm going to get some music for you. We're going to get ready to do a little warm-up. Let's start with those. Actually, let's go first position. I'm going to do just a little warm-up with your feet. I've been watching some of the classes on blocks, and they've been having some really great ballet classes and some different things, and I've noticed really some awesome technicians, so I want to really get that same vibe going on for you guys.
What's
so
up, buddy?
I'm going to get you guys some music, and we're going to see what we got going on.
So you can see yourself in the mirror.
Just a little bit, so I know if I'm doing good.
Okay, how does it feel for volume? Is that okay? Not too loud?
All right.
Yeah.
All right. How about here? Feel good about this? Good. Let's just plie and push that right heel down. And down. And down. And down. Good. Now let's just plie. Hold.
Yes, Autumn.
Right. Let's train. Beautiful. Try to test that balance. I love the arms so tall and high. Yes. Ribcage closed. And back to your center. Beautiful. Open those arms. We're just going to do the same thing one more time now. You know what we're doing? Right foot. Reach. And feet. And open. And two. And left. And three. And lift. Four. We're going to roll. Push down. Down. Heels. Lift. And lower, and down, and push, and lift. Let's reverse. Tall, sit up, heels over, down, push into the floor. Think ribcage closed. Yes. Take your time and just elevate. Slow, guys. Can you bring your arms to your tallest point? Tallest. Can we go with the left foot? Test it. Really think about where you want to be. Yes. This is nice. Gorgeous. Back to your center. Everybody relax that tension. Got it. Good. Toes down on the ground. I love it. Yes. Back to your center. Open those arms for me. Let's plie. And let's go flat back. Let's just relax it.
more. Down for two and stretch. Last one. Down for two and stretch. Let's bring those arms forward towards us. Yes. We open and arch that back when we release it. Relax the tension. Guys, I like it. Let's go to the second position. You should start to feel that body getting a little warmer. Good. Can we just go here for me? Down.
Yes, Autumn.
Hold this position for me.
holding on to it. Let's take some bot paws down and up. Hands down. And then. And down. And then. Nice. Notice right behind your head. That's the hardest part. Keep it behind the nose. Down. And up. And down. And up. Yes. Down. And up. Let's hold and work towards your highest pulse. Up. Up. Good. Three. And four. Five. Six. Seven. Hold and stay for me. Good. Nice and tight. Now we're going to slide it down. Be careful of what's around you. This is your left leg split. I'm sure I have some lefties out there. Most of us are righties, but we like that left side. You can always do a half split. I wanted to show what that looks like just to make sure. So if you want to go half on your left, you can. If you're ready to push through, you can go nice and full. Arms tall to the ceiling. Right shoulder forward. Good. Reach and give it a good stretch, guys. Think about that belly button really reaching out. Feels so nice. Four, three, two. Let's leave those hands on the floor and open. Slide them back. Open that chest. Release if you can. Good. And we'll bring those arms back up one more time. Reaching forward. Over. Eight. Nice. And we're going to slide those hands on the floor. Opening up the chest. Nice. Good. And if you go down, take a hold of that foot. Now what we're going to do is you're going to take it with you. You're going to roll it backwards. And it's going to push all the way down. So notice that it's over the top of her nose. Now the tighter you get, you can pull those elbows so they can stay a little bit tighter to your face. Just breathe. Stay long through your neck, whether it's here, here, or here. Now we're going to open it to the side with one hand. So it's going to be your left hand. Other hand is going to hit that floor. Nice and strong. Good. Closing the ribs. Engaging, making sure the back's flat on the ground. Good. I like this here. Breathing. Let's bring it back over the nose. Deep breath. Easy. Nice. We're going to slowly let it go. Four, three, two. Now we're just going to cross it here. We're going to try a couple little small sit-ups here, more like a crunch. Breathing in and out through the nose. So on the way up, we breathe out. In through the nose. And down. And lift. And down. Good. Notice that our ribs are closed and the back is so flat. Making sure that you're not opening, closing the rib cage. Lift. We're going to do eight a little faster. Here we go. And it's eight, seven, six, good. Five, four, three, two. Take a break. Breathe and stretch it out. Woo! Feels good. Okay, we got our left side done. You ready for your right? So now, right leg's coming in the front. Lunge position is coming through the back. Four little pulses. We go. Four, and three, and two, and one. Again, notice how parallel this is. So nice. Do it again. It's down. And two, and three, and
yes,
four.
Autumn.
Stretch it up. She's working hard this morning.
What's the parallel for?
And go. What'd you say?
What's the parallel for?
Well, parallel is when you want to make sure that you're in the right position here so that you're actually getting the hamstring stretch, which is right here. A lot of people like to move their leg right over here on the side, and you're really, now your hips are all out of line, so you want to make sure that everything is straight and parallel on. How about flexing that front foot for me? Feels kind of good. Woo! Good, now we're going to lower the toes, and you can walk your hands forward. So you want to see if you have this nice ponche position, some people like to call it a needle. It's up to you. We're going to do some bahas, big toes touching the floor. Four, eight, it's one, and lift. Nice, two, and lift. Good job. Three, lift. Four, nice and strong, guys, straight behind your nose. And it's hard not to arch your back, so hold your core tight. Stay. Top. Now we're going to pulse from the top. Let's push up. So she's going towards the mirror, straight up, 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 up. Nice. Hold and stay for me. Hold this position. Now be careful what's around you again. We're sliding down into the right leg split. Excellent. Shoulder forward, which is your left one. Sometimes we get open like this in our splits. We want to make sure we're here. Arms tall. Reaching forward. Over. Yes. I'm hearing snapping and crackling and popping. And I don't know if it's my body. I think it's yours. Sliding it back. Opening up that chest. Try to stay relaxed if you can. Excellent. Good. Let's go one more time. Top, up and over. You guys are doing great. Warm-up is hard. I'm really focused on warm-up because it might want to make it hard for you, but strong because this is how your core is going to happen. Open for me. Chest top. Good. Down and grab that foot. You're going to pull it over with you so you're rolling over that left shoulder. Everything's nice and tight and square. Over that right eye. Really control here. Good. Nice. And then she's going to open to the side position. So she's going to take that right arm and it's going to open up into a muscle. Left hand is going to come to the side of the pool. Try to keep that body as straight as you can. Nice.
Autumn, do you imagine that you're in a leg hold and you're turning right now?
Yeah. She's going to be back over that nose for me. Keeping it nice and strong and square. Yes. Good. This leg's going to the floor. We're going to repeat those mini little crunches. Think about that breath. Out through the mouth, in through the nose. Little susu. Here we go. It's slow. Breathe out. In through the nose. In. Out. Oh, yeah. Abs are tight. Think about how great your balance is going to be. Lift. And down. And lift. And down. And lift. And down. Good. A little faster. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Give me one more set of 8. You got this. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Everyone take a break. Breathe. Last 2 minutes of warm-up. So, those of you who've ever taken my class before or seen any of my classes, I really hone in on the warm-up. Because the stronger we can work for being, the core being nice and tight and strong, it's really going to be helpful. Some people just plop into the splits and they're ready to go, and it's not the best way to warm up your body. It's really important that we work towards balance and we work towards core. We figure out how that center works. So I want you to hug these knees for me. Relaxing the shoulders, give them a nice hug. Now we're going to try to go to our second position. So that means your middle split. So visualizing yourself in your most beautiful leap in second, where your body is long and tall. Now you have to keep your back flat on the floor. That's the hardest part, is a lot of people want to arch or bring their shoulders up, so you really want to stay in this position. Now Autumn's pretty flexible, so hers pretty much hits the floor. But what I love is that her body is always straight up and down when she does this jump or this stretch or this leap. And everything is nice and long in this position. I want you to just try to relax. A lot of people push and pump. I would rather you just hold and stay. And if it's too much pressure, you can always release and take a little break there, or you can push down. Usually in this position, I make my students stay here for probably an entire song, which they don't like me for. So we're not going to quite do that because we don't have all that time. So right now, last thing we're going to try is we're going to put our hands on the floor. We're going to flex those feet. We're going to work for your inner thigh muscles. So think about your grand plie. We're actually going to lift and squeeze. So it's 4, 3, 2. You're going to make a little susu at the top. So these are my inner thigh muscles, and then I'm going to open. 2, 3. Lifting and squeezing is really important for your olecranon turns. And we're going to open. Slow, slow. Nice. And again, up. 2, 3, 4. And lower. 2, 3. I know these are tiring. You got this. 4, 3, 2, 1. And open. Last one. We're going to hold it to the top. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now I want you to bend your knees in for me. We're going to come to our elbows. I'm going to ask you maybe to turn sideways just so we can, just so you can see her upper body. You notice like
what's up,
the back is so flat, the chest is tall. This is like so nice. When a lot of times I give this exercise, everybody kind of hunches into this. So last thing, lower abs. We're going to lift those legs to the top, nice and strong, slowly to the floor. 4, 3, 2. Try not to touch. Can you bring them up? Yes! Oh, and this doesn't get any easier, does it, Autumn? 4, 3, 2, 1. And she lifts. Good. Again. And 4, 3, 2, 1. This is your last one. Ready? We're holding at the bottom. We're going to meet you. Have this slow. Yes. Yes. Beat and go for me. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You made it. That wasn't so bad. This was like a 20-minute warm-up, which I wanted to do with you. In my regular classes, I probably do 30 to 35 minutes, so you got a mini glimpse of what we kind of do and work here. So I want you to really think about what your body is. Water if you need it.
Autumn, what do you think about when you're like, your stomach's burning the last like 10 seconds? What is on your mind? Just like get through it, or what do you think about?
Yeah, I think so.
Making
but
it work.
Yeah, I like that. I think it's good, and I think we talk a lot about muscle memory and repetition. So if I want a nice bicep, I have to go to the gym and literally do this every day to create something.
Same thing with dance. We have to, especially the technique, is learn how to do things over and over and over correctly, especially all the body placement that happens, especially my class. It's a lot of all the pieces that are going to go into all the choreography and the combos that you're going to do in all your other styles, whether it's lyrical, jazz, hip-hop, contemporary, anything that you're going to use, all this stuff is going to go into that. So what we're going to try, we're going to do some batmas. Batmas, sometimes like people like to call them a kick. I like to make sure that we know that they really look the same, even though they have two different words. We want to make sure that it's going through first position every single time that you step through. Everything pushes and stays turned out. The chest lifts nice and tall. We're going to try an exercise that doesn't travel too much, so hopefully you have some room here. We're going to go from one side to the other, maybe about 4 feet you might need if you can find it. Let's see if we can try two batmas going front. We're going to step across for the third batma going side, and then we're going to take a small turning pas de bourrée around. A nice little easy traveling combo across the floor, yeah. I like to do. We're going to do a little demonstration first.
Anything you think about when you do this, Odd, that you want to tell these 600 people out there?
Just make sure you're brushing through first and like fast up, slow down, just like make it effective almost. Like, because I feel like a lot of people just like batma now and you don't think about it because it's like something that's so like repetition for people. People are like, oh, kicks are so easy or batmas are so easy. Mm-hmm. Like, I've been doing them since I was like 6 years old too. So it's like, even though I still do them like whatever, so many times a week, it's like you have to like find new things to like just challenge your own self. So like if you think this is easy or you think this is hard, like you can like, always find something to make it harder.
I think too, everyone's super excited about kicks being so high. Like, I just want to get my leg up there. They'll do anything to get their body crazy instead of really thinking about where it's going to be. So I want you to really use your body position and your poise and your core, all the work that we just did right now in those batmas. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm going to let Autumn do a little demonstration for you, and then I'll get some music so we can try it.
Put your hands together for Autumn Miller, everyone. Bravo, bravo.
All right, here we go. Excuse me. Six, seven, two batmas front. Two, we're gonna step across side, down, up, up, and one, and two, and side, and down, up, up. Excellent. Now I know that traveled kind of far, so maybe we'll do one. We'll give you a little break so that you can back up if you need to, whether you're in your house or your garage or you're outside, or maybe you're fortunate enough to be in a studio like us. We're also gonna do everything on the left. I am a big fan of left. I know it's hard. As dancers, we are athletes. We have to be ambidextrous, right?
Look at those muscles, man. Damn.
Okay, I'm going to get you guys a little bit of music.
Whoa, Autumn. Those are big muscles, too.
Let's think about these batmas. What do we got? Okay.
What does batma mean again?
Batma means to brush.
To brush. Oh, yeah. Like brush your teeth or no?
Well, I mean, I'm
just kidding. All right. Any advice, Autumn, before they start batmas?
Okay. Just try it. Oh, well, if you mess up.
Okay, we're getting ready to step on that left foot. Batma on the right. Six, five, six. Here we go. It's right and left and right. Down, up, up. Stop for me. We're going to try it again. So you have some room if you need to back up. It's five and six. And five, six, here we go. It's one, and two, step across, stop, down, up, up. Excellent, we're gonna come back on the left. So preparing your mind for left side. Here we go, it's five, six, seven, and five, left. Step across right, kick left, one, two, and three. We're gonna back it up again, get some room for me. Left foot, it's five.
Dancers, hips.
Dancers are hard to work. Here we go. Five, six, last one, and it's right, and left, and side. One more time, it's right, and side. Hey, one, two, three, breathe. Good, notice the body's nice and tall, and she's brushing through first.
Yes, Autumn Miller.
How are you doing? Yeah. Breathe in. That was a hard one. Kind of get the heart rate flowing. I like that because a lot of the classes right now through the Instagram or Zooms, sometimes they don't get your heart rate going. You're just learning a combo, but you're actually not getting that movement. We also want to make sure we're building our stamina still during this time when things are a little bit, well, are truly stagnant. So we want to make sure that we have that going on. Let's try something a little slower. Let's take a little bit more control and dive short of bottom. I think let's go forward on this one. Let's go side. I think side work. But you have the option to go forward if you have more room. Need water? You okay? She's like, I'm breathing.
She's like, more like I need a coffee.
Coffee, water, all of the above.
Just kidding.
Okay, let's try doing two bottoms front. We're going to brush through first, come through our posse. Then all I want you to do is come to your back attitude. I want you to plie here, and then I want you to stretch it through into your arabesque at the back. Two, brushing, come through your passe into plie attitude, then extend into your arabesque. I'm gonna let her do one demonstration, and I think this is pretty self-explanatory, something that you guys can try. Okay, let's try one. Six.
Put your heads together for Autumn.
Seven, hey! Seven, eight, it's one. And two, we're gonna brush through, come through passe. Now she's gonna plie in her back attitude. She has the same arm as leg, and then when she's ready, she's gonna extend into her arabesque. Gorgeous. We do one more. It's one, and two. She's gonna brush through plie, come through your passe, plie in your back attitude, and then she extends through arabesque. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Notice that the core is really strong and tight the whole time. A lot of times when we start making our kicks happen, we do everything, we move everything around instead of holding everything. So this set of abs needs to stay completely tight so that when you move, nothing is happening in here. This is what holds you together, okay?
So that's why we did all those sit-ups.
Yes, that's why we did it. Let's get some music. Can you need some water? Right,
I got a question for Autumn. What keeps you motivated, like to even work hard? Like today, there's no reason to work hard because it's just another day. And we're here obviously doing this class, but what keeps you wanting to be better?
I think you just have to push yourself, no matter what, if you want the end goal or whatever your end goal may be. Maybe it's not even to be a dancer, but you're choosing to be a dancer in that moment. So putting your 100% into that moment, I guess.
That's good advice. Yeah, no, it's true. That's how you get better.
Yeah. Try to find something kind of slow so we're not rushed. Does this make sense? Okay. So let's think about this. Could be down, up, rush, passe, plie, six, all, seven, and eight. Something in that zone. I think that's going to work for you guys. Relax the tension in our mouth. Last set of bottoms. Here we go. It's five, six, step on the left foot, one and two. Brush through. Bring your passe. Plie. Yes. And extend. Gorgeous. Let's try one more time, guys. Make sure you have your room. Here it comes. It's five and six. And five, six, seven, eight. It's one and two. Step and brush. Beautiful. I love this. Hold that three back out.
So are you better at right or left?
Right.
Left side is hard, but if you're a lefty, it's hard because you got to be a righty all the time.
True.
Okay, setting for the left. It's five, six, here we go. Left and right. You're going to brush through with the left foot. Pull back underneath your passe. Plie into your arabesque. And then close those ribs as you lift. Beautiful. One more. Five, six. Here we go. It's left foot and right foot. Brush through. Nice. She pulls back with that hand. Love it. Broad up the tall. Extend and stay. Hey.
Not bad for left. You want some water on?
Yeah, I need some water. You breathe. I know that's the hard part. Sometimes we are not taking care of our bodies, right? Hydrating is a good part. She's just working hard, going and going and going, and I want her to
breathe for a second, because sometimes that's a lot of pressure, you know, in front of you guys, just having to be able to be on at the crack of snap and say, okay, I'm getting ready to do this. I think sometimes too, especially like Autumn, a lot of people think she's a robot. They say a lot of things on Instagram and they think that, you know, we just turn her on and she does these things. I want you to remember she's taking class right now alongside you. Same thing. Think about how she's doing these things. She's allowed to make mistakes. I make mistakes. You make mistakes. And in class, you should be making mistakes, because class is where you actually want to make those mistakes so that you can take corrections from me or other instructors so that you can actually apply those things to get better. Dance is a journey and it takes a very long time. We're gonna go have highs, we're gonna have lows, we're gonna plateau. But if you're taking corrections and you have the want and the drive to be better, you will. But you also have to put the hard work and the sweat and the blood and the tears and some days going, yes, I wanna do this, no, I don't, I'm tired, I'm hot, I'm hungry, all of these things. The dance life is hard, but it's very, very rewarding. So I don't want you to give up on things like that. And I also want you to realize she's worked really hard on all of these things as well. Sometimes we only see the end result or the end product, and she's been doing this since she was this big, and now the muscle memory has kind of turned into what she is today. So I do want you to kind of remember that as you're working towards whatever goal it is for you. That brings me to turns.
Uh-oh.
Something kind of fun, yes? I think for me, turns is probably my favorite thing to teach, just because a lot of people don't teach it. So I like being able to kind of break down different things about a turn. Now your level may be here, 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 so you can choose to work to your highest level. I really wanna just dive into some coupe turns, something like that, which is a difficult turn, but something that I think that you've probably, if you are, you know, at least an intermediate dancer, will know what to do. I'm working on jazz technique with you guys, Autumn and I are. So I want you to realize that my preps are gonna be parallel. They're not gonna be turned out today. So what I want you to think about when you're going into this prep is gonna be second, back, side, parallel. So notice everything. Think about parallel, two lines that do not cross or intersect. Everything is flat. So when I'm going here and I'm gonna push down, the minute I take off, everything turns out. So I'm actually gonna be in that coupe turn because everything will turn completely out the minute I hit the back. Something else that I like to do is I like to make sure that my arms are a little lower than what most people like. So if you're not used to it, try it today and see if it works. It's not right or wrong, it's just what I prefer and that I see works for my students. So low here from the belly and then straight out. This is more of like a traditional ballet first high. So I challenge you today with your jazz turns to just lower it down. So think about this too with your coupe. Your pinky toe is really touching that shin bone. You're pulling back with the knee and there's actual space. There's space in between here. So I want you to think about that, you know?
Are those block shoes you got on there,
Aunt? Yeah, she's got some new turning shoes on.
It's a blocks. What are those? Are those block gear you
guys have? We got our gear today. How are we looking?
Not bad. I like it. Those, yeah, it's good.
Cute, right? Okay, so let's just break this down. I'm going to see Bottom will just do a little demonstration. A little demonstration for you. And I want you to think about what the positioning looks like, and then we're going to try it together. So four little sets. Easy Bottom work. Six. 7, 8, it's 1, 2, 3, tall, ooh, hey, and around, gorgeous. I like to finish my turns in second for the sole reason so she can figure out where that balance is or if the ankles are rolling, something for you to hold on to. Can we try that right side one more time? That was beautiful.
Now,
sometimes those turns turn out like that, right? Sometimes they don't. But more than likely, she gets a very consistent run because of the way she has trained her body to be. One more time. 6, 7, 8. It's 1, 2, 3. Nice and easy lift. And around. Gorgeous.
What do you think about Ott when you do this?
I don't think one
You don't think That's anymore?
The best part. You don't have to anymore, huh? Yeah. Is that crazy?
I mean, I obviously like, I think the biggest thing for me is making sure my prep set up right, because I feel like if I rush into it too fast or like I'm a little wobbly, then like I already know that the turn's gonna be bad. Yeah. So you just kind of like, I feel like the prep is like what's big for me is like really staying like grounded and then being like, okay, like it's gonna go the way it's gonna go, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But
it's really nice.
And after doing it so many times, you're actually, your body's in the right place.
If you freak out like, or something, if like the first one's bad, like you can fix it with your core. Like maybe like my first one's a little shaky, but then like I can actually end it nicely because I found my core. I feel like some people, like, if your first one's shaky, you kind of just give up and then, like,
or bend the knee in the bottom and then it causes hopping instead of using the core tight.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to ask you guys to do two sets going right and two sets going left. I know you're not going to like me for that, but I definitely want to reward my lefties out there and know that when I am literally teaching a true class, both sides, right and left. Now bring your number down if you're not a lefty. Bring it down to a single, double, triple if you want to try. Now is the chance to go ahead and make that mistake and think about low arms. Think about your turnout. How is your neck going to stay long so that you actually can spot? It's going to be really nice. Got to have a positive vibe going on for that. And I'm going to get you guys some music. We're going to attempt two sets going right with a little hold in the middle and two sets going left. Doable, guys.
How many do you think you're going to do right now?
I don't know.
What's your average?
Seven
or eight, okay, let's count them.
Oh gosh, it's not.
I'll count you. Just a tiny bit more music. How's that for volume? You okay, guys? All right. No pressure. This is practice, everybody. Practice. Across the floor. In five, six, here we go. One, two, three. Easy. Hey, gorgeous. Stay here again. Five, six.
That was six, right?
Let's go to the left. Bring it down for a double. Or a triple.
Yes, Autumn.
Build on this turn. One more little thing.
Sure.
One more little thing. How about going from coupe to a small little arabesque? Is that something we can do? I kind of like this one. This one's a little inconsistent. Why would you say it's inconsistent? Or why do you think it's inconsistent? I know.
Just because of your ribcage.
Ribcage is opening, right? Kind of come this way. So think about this. We're going to try that exact same turn. And all we're going to do is keep the thighs tight and together. And we're going to rotate it into a small little arabesque that's low to the floor. So think about almost your fourth position here and lifting up that back foot so it's just nice and tight and controlled. The arm is going to come nice and all here, so the right arm is going to stay in this position as well. You want to try this for me? See what it looks like?
Sure.
Okay, let's try it. Five, six, seven, eight. It's one, two, three. Lift. And then it comes around. Yes, gorgeous. One more time. Seven, eight, and one, two, three. She holds that core so tight and she squeezes and lifts up and out of that hip. Ooh, beautiful.
Wow. Cool.
That's awesome. Yeah. What, did you feel anything different from the first one to the second one?
My prep on the first one, I cut it a little short. I think my prep was a little too small. But yeah, when you said lift up, I kind of just.
You came right out of your hips. I watched you go.
Yeah.
Straight up and out. And then she was actually able to get that third one and it just rotated. It was like, hey, I'm here. So think about this one last time and then we're going to try it together. Here, tight thighs, rondes de jambe, stay to your back and here are your arms. Nothing open here, closed and connected with everything nice and taut. We're going to try two sets right, two sets left. Again, bring your numbers down or if you're like, I got this turn, go for those triple-triple or quad-quad. Something fun for a challenge for yourself. Okay, I think my condition does solve here. Let's see what we got.
You can't do these on point, huh? This would be. Is this done on point ever?
No.
No. This is jazz.
This is a jazz technique.
Okay, you breathe deep, guys?
Yeah.
Remember, practice across the floor. If you make a mistake, it's okay. Here we go. It's five, and six, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three. Push down, hold. All right. Yes. Nice. Again. Nine, six, seven. Show off that press. You worked hard for it. Hey. Nice. Going left. Here we go. Nice easy double. Push. Shouldery in here, biting everything instead of like really staying long and low. So I want to make sure that this position does kind of have that long and low feeling. Yeah? Let's remove our shoes for a bit. And do you think we could jump or so? Think we could do a little jumper show? Some jumper show? How are your legs feeling? Hopefully good. Thumbs up. Water if you need it. I'm liking those kinds of turns. Now, depending on your space, if you have it, I'm going to have you kind of cruise around, and if you don't, I understand. So see what you could do in this position. You could always go back to doing those turns while we're trying the jumps. But I'd love to give you a true kind of vision of like what a jazz class is with us, which is where we do a little bit of kicks, we do a little bit of turning, a little bit of jumping, some fun stuff like that. I wanted to just talk about maybe what it looks like for a fun little calypso.
Sure.
Is that something doable?
Yes.
Now we usually do these with the high chenet first and then a low chenet just because we love the idea of traveling. But being that we're in the tighter space today, I think that we'll just take it with one low chenet going into the calypso. Is that something we can try?
Sure.
So I'm going to have you demonstrate one, and I'm going to show you the position that it's in case you're not familiar. 6, 7, 8 is low chenet, up, and around. Yes, so we'll just do one because I think that it feels weird to not yell, so like, keep it on going, and keep it on going. You're like, hold on for a second. So think about it. She's doing a low chenet, or chenet is a plie. And the plie is still turned out, so we're going here, we're making this chenet happen. And then what's gonna happen is this leg brushes under as she comes through, the arms are gonna open here, and then that back leg is in back attitude. Could you just show me what it looks like on the floor? So remember, kind of like your half split. And what she gets pretty high and can kind of make hers a little contorted, like her body can move. And if you're at that level too, that's awesome, because you can kind of make this jump your own. But if you're just starting off or working towards making this happen, you want to make sure that your body is still facing the front, so everything is here and open. And you can also release your neck or your head if you want to. It's really up to you. So one low chenet, pushing into this nice big jump as this rotates around. I want to try this. Some people also call this jump a Baryshnikov. So there's a lot of different names for things in dance. Again, it's kind of what you were brought up training with or the methods that you've, you know, been comfortable with. But we kind of call this a calypso, which is traditionally a jazz, and a Baryshnikov is more of like the ballet version. So
yeah.
Motioning and up. We'll just go back and trade for a minute. We'll do it again. We'll kind of make just two sets going right, two sets going left. How are you doing, guys? Excellent day.
Any advice you have for this jump?
Really use your legs. Like I said, it's hard to do it with just one chenet if you're like focusing on height. But it's honestly a good challenge because then when you do have room, hopefully it'll be better and higher.
Yes. Here we go. So we're going to take one row chenet, really thinking about where you're at.
Yes, Autumn Miller. Okay, it's 9:44, just
okay,
so you know.
One more quick little jump, and then at 9:48, we're gonna be able to start doing some fun questions for you. How about that? This one's just something that's gonna take, that's something that's easy to do in a small space. So I just want to go step, step, sauté, step, 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 sauté, arabesque, step, 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 and jump. When you go into that arabesque position, I want you to really push off the floor with that foot. Those arms are coming nice and high here. And then step, step, and step, lift, step, step. This is kind of a cardio jump, kind of like get your body finishing up so that we can answer some fun questions. We'll kind of push through our last 2 minutes. Can you do it? We're going to do two sets of four.
Right.
Two sets of four. We're stepping on the right foot.
Two sets of four.
Two sets of four. You're gonna love me for this. You'll thank me later. Five, six, seven, five. Here we go. And six, jump.
Everyone, give it up for Autumn Miller and Krista Miller.
That song just makes you happy. There's just nothing, I don't know, there's something about that song. I don't get tired of that one. That's a fine one. Did you guys have a good dance? A good dance lesson this morning, this evening, this morning, wherever you are, or morning still. Yes, hopefully. I'm going to turn on those comments. We're going to answer some questions. How about that?
Yeah.
What do we got?
Maybe we should turn it around.
Ooh, we'd love to. Can we turn it so we can see?
Set it down, maybe right here.
I love that. Can we set you guys over here? Fun.
How's that?
Yeah, that's perfect. Okay, what do we got?
Everyone's just saying hi.
Hi. It was
you
so
two
fun.
Are amazing.
Oh, thank you.
What's up, Emma?
Hey.
So fun.
Thank you. You're so
Michelle.
Welcome.
Woohoo.
Anybody got any questions for us?
How can you improve on your height and your jumps?
That's so hard. That's a good question. So height and the jumps, think about this. I like doing even just exercises where you have to use the floor in order to push up every single time. So a lot of times everybody's jumping and they're thinking split. And sometimes the split is low and down instead of up and high. So even like this exercise of really pushing off the floor, or if you've seen any of my other online classes where I'm doing the sautés and learning how to really push through and just using your floor and your plié is a really great thing for your jumps.
Someone asked them, have you ever done World of Dance? Someone said.
Oh. No, I do not do World of Dance.
Are extensions really important in jazz?
Yes, we do a lot of extensions, but they're not like vital. It's not something you have to have.
Yeah, I wouldn't worry about it, like just having a nice extension. If it's low, that's fine. I think people can always work on flexibility.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Do you have any tips for higher releve, someone said?
Oh, more releves. Doing them all the time.
Releves,
your inside that arch will actually start to stretch. Believe it or not, the more you do it and the higher your releve is, it will start to open up.
Turning, lots of things.
Where is your arm placement on turns?
I like to go belly button out, low, right here. Straight out.
Really low, yeah.
Instead of tall.
Tips for spotting on turns?
Mm-hmm. Spotting. I think the longer your neck is, the easier it is to kind of make that whip happen. A lot of people get in here and you can't spot it all. So really thinking long.
Yeah, you can like play games with your friends and like say they're holding a water bottle or like numbers on their hand. And every time you have to like see what number you saw to like make sure you're actually getting your spotting right. I do that with some of my students.
Someone asked if you were born naturally flexible or did you have to work for it?
Kind of both. I feel like I always like had my hips naturally a little bit more flexible, but I'm still very tight in my hamstrings, but I feel like I've definitely worked for a lot of my flexibility and strength and stuff in general. Tips on doing multiple pirouettes. I think honestly, like getting from like 3 to 5 or like 4 to 5, 5 to 6 is like the hardest because I feel like a lot of people are stuck at like 3 and 4 turns. And it's honestly, I think the like prep. For me, it's like if I don't push off or use enough like power in my prep, it's just not going anywhere. And if you can balance for 5 or 6 counts, you should be able to do 5 or 6 turns because that's like all throughout your core. Straight knees is a really big one, I feel like.
Someone asked about, this is interesting, dance tricks. Does that make you a better dancer if you have more tricks?
I don't think it makes you a better dancer. I think if you are going to go on auditions and you have some tricks, it might give you some other options of things. Like say you make it down to the very end and they ask who can do back handsprings or does anybody have any what we call special skills. Sometimes that might be something that would be more inviting for them to hire you.
Mm-hmm. I think it depends on who's watching. If you dancers, the whole idea is to entertain and to move somebody and to tell a story with it. So I think the more storytelling, and then sometimes tricks are powerful because they like wow the audience. But I think it depends on if you're connected to the music and connected to what you're doing. Anyway, can you give some tips on back flexibility? Why did you stop competing?
It was just time. I think some people just grow out of it, or you feel like you've reached your peak at that, and I think I just wanted to push myself in other ways because I was starting to feel comfortable competing. And so I think you always want to make sure you're on your toes about like learning what's new or what's upcoming and next.
Yeah, someone asked if the Brea Space was an actual dance studio or just like a training center.
Just training. We don't compete here.
Yeah, we don't compete.
Tips on illusions, tips for higher extensions, exercises for flexibility. Maybe we'll do that, like another class sometime on flexibility.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah.
I like that.
You're so welcome.
Maggie.
Some people were asking how important or like how many hours do you need to do jazz technique? I think people are saying, and I think it doesn't really matter about the hours or whatever it is, as long as you're getting good education and say it's like you're doing it like 1 or 2 or 3 hours a week, if you're putting your 100% into it, and that's going to be better than doing 30 minutes a day or whatever, because sometimes you just don't get enough out of that.
When's your next classes? You have to go to thespace.tv to find out more about that.
Yeah.
Or maybe we'll do another one sometime on block.
Would love flexibility. Except exercises for doing
various turns.
Practice and repeat with that one. I mean, literally over and over. Even that four step, whether it's a pirouette or a pencil turn or a coupe, all of those things are just going to be repetition. You want to make sure that your prep is really solid.
Yeah, I think... Yeah, this leg will be saved on here for 24 hours.
Yeah,
still
24 hours for sure.
Tips on getting better back flexibility.
You want to just try? What do we do? Back, like just,
me,
I like to walk down the wall.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't really like focus on back flexibility just because I think that's a little dangerous and I've injured my back a couple of times. So I think having almost a too flexible back is a little scary. But if you know how to control it and you have the right strength, it's really good. I think just remembering to stretch it every day, doing simple back bends or simple bridges, you might not even notice how much like just little things like that help. Look up like strengthening back exercises because that actually opens your back more too.
That's good.
What conventions are you assisting next year? Well, at the moment, we
don't
really know, but we'll see. As of right now, I mean, Dance Awards and Dancerpalooza, who knows, they might end up being online, but I was doing those larger than life. I assist Mark Miesmer on Nuvo a lot, so hopefully next season we'll be back touring with them, and I'll be assisting on some of those. Tips for illusions. That's just a complicated situation, to be honest.
For illusions, I think you want to make sure, too, like your head and your leg are in line. So when your head goes down, that leg is coming up in the opposite time frame. So kind of like what I would call a teeter-totter. I think a lot of people drop their chest.
Yeah, so just
people said you inspire them.
Aw, thank you.
That's nice.
Someone asked what your favorite dance was.
Oh, like
style of dance. Style of dance.
Favorite style? I don't know. It always differs, like lyrical, jazz. I don't know. I like everything, but those are my top two.
What is your favorite style, which we just did? Any tips for leaps in second? What is your favorite skill? Tips on back flexibility. By the way, my name's Corey. Someone asked who was filming.
That's Dad.
We're a family over here. Family of three.
What advice do you have for young dancers? I think just like looking at people who inspire you and looking up to those people and wanting to not be them but aspire to fall under their path, or you need to kind of find an all over like person, because I feel like sometimes we just look at their amazing talent and what they are, but you kind of want to know their back history and like what they're all about. So I think
They're humans, not just dancers, right?
Yeah, so just like
that. I've seen a couple that talk about leaps in second, and I want you to think about when you're in a leap in second, keeping your chest lifted so that your arms are flat and square and they're open. A lot of times everyone does a leap in second and pushes their booty kind of to the back wall, so you want to make sure that your booty is facing the floor in the leap in second and your chest is really tall.
Mm-hmm. Hip flexor stretches other than the basics.
Honestly, we like to roll. Even
we
on a tennis
use
ball.
A lot of tennis balls or foam rollers. That might be a basic, but I'm not sure.
Kind of rolling those out sometimes because I feel like our hip flexors get really tight.
And Pilates too, I think, helps put those in the right positions and strengthen them.
Where
do you
learn
the
basics?
I mean, during Corona, do you recommend a channel?
That's a hard one. Honestly, I've been asked that a lot. And there isn't a ton of beginning like content out there. So
Autumn, maybe you
really
should teach a beginning class.
Yeah, you never know. It's a good idea for us. Maybe we'll start working on that for
you. Yeah, this life will be saved, guys. Don't worry. I'm 18.
Tips for remembering choreography.
Oh, that's so hard. Putting your head in the game and doing it.
Just going for it.
How many hours do you train working out personally?
I mean, we don't really, I mean, dance is like our workout. I don't know if that's what you mean or.
The class will be saved.
Yeah, we're going to save it.
When doing the preps, I couldn't read that one. They're going too fast.
They're going fast. They're going really fast.
Can you oversplit? How can you, I don't know, I missed it. What types of dance do you?
Tips for splits. I mean, basically sometimes we use the little yoga blocks. And we stack those up. We do not, we're not big over split people like five or six. We'll do like one or two and then kind of practice those splits that way.
Mm-hmm. Any exercise?
Someone asked tips for food, like diet. Hmm. Like what do you try to do for eating?
I mean, I think it's all about a balance. You need to have those fun candies and sweets and chocolates and whatever. But you also have to remember that what you put in your body is what you're going to get out of it. So if you have maybe bad skin or something and you keep eating the cookies and keep eating the ice cream, that could be affecting your body and the way you're portraying yourself, where you say you want a better body but you keep eating those things. You have to make a change for yourself.
And the Brea space, it's located in Orange County. So we're in California, Southern California, yeah. And we do have open classes, but we're closed right now. Hopefully you'll open back up in July. Mm-hmm.
Tips for balance,
a lot of releves and a lot of core work. The stronger your core is, the better your balance is going to be.
Yeah.
Well,
we have 1 minute.
Yeah, so maybe you guys want to say your last things.
Well, you guys, this was actually a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. I want to thank Block for letting us host this class. Hopefully we can do another one with you guys. It was awesome. I love the questions about education. Keep educating yourself, keep practicing, and keep dancing.
Yeah, definitely. We had so much fun. Yeah, we hope to do this again soon. Thank you all for joining in. And my name's Autumn.
Yes,
this is my mom.
Krista, and there's Dad, Corey.
Yeah, so
have a great day, guys. We hope to see you in another class very soon.
Remember, technique is really important. Bye.